Herstory. Today on the show, we have America's original Mustang, Sally. Sally Ride!
Hello.
Ride, Sally Ride.
Ah, yes, the old Ride, Sally Ride joke.
I am having to hold in my excited throw up because you are a heroine of science and life. June 18th, 1983. History is made in the United States because you, that space shuttle challenger, you put on your seatbelt and you said, take off! And you went up into the space. You were the first woman to do it, Sally Ride, in the United States of America, and also the youngest person in history, 32 years old. How did you get into astronauting? Were you scouted? Did someone see you on the street and say, you?
Yeah, it was.
You look like you have a stomach for anti-gravity.
Actually, in 1977, I was finishing up my PhD in astrophysics at Stanford University.
Oh.
I was reading the paper one day, and NASA had taken out an ad looking for astronauts.
Incredible.
I circled the ad and applied.
How did you celebrate getting into NASA? Did you buy yourself a new pair of shoes? Or moon boots? If you had not become an astronaut, there's a very good chance you might have played Venus and Serena Williams on the old tennis court.
Tennis, yes.
True, you had quite a knack with the tennis rack. Yet.
Before I went to college, I was actually ranked 18th in the nation.
Amazing!
Billie Jean King, the famous tennis player who beat Bobby Riggs, really wanted me to go pro, and I disappointed her a little bit when I decided to go to college instead. But I won her back when I became an astronaut.
Not to make a historical quibble, but while you were the first American woman in space, you were not the first woman in space. That accolade actually goes to, of course, cosmonaut Valentina Tereshkova.
Tereshkova.
That lady Russian cosmonaut went up into space in 1963. What gives? Or should I say, what gave?
I think it took so long for the United States to get a woman into space because of a lot of outdated fears about whether women could physically, mentally, emotionally stand the conditions of space.
Oh.
But what I always said was that weightlessness is the great equalizer.
Becoming the first woman in space put you in every history book, and I'm sure got you a lot of dates. Mm-mm. However, there was a downside, which was fielding so many inane questions from befuddled journalists about you being a woman in space.
They put me under the microscope to make a science joke.
Did you wear a brassiere in space? I was a little curious.
Thought I was done with these questions in the 80s.
Did you wear space makeup?
Why would I wear makeup in space?
I will retract my question. How would you describe the experience of being in space?
The thing I remember most about space is that it was fun.
I mean, it was space.
How could space not be fun? Well, except for Apollo 13. Fun after, though. You know, when they were like, whew, made it. It's actually getting a little warm in here.
You little breather. How do I look? Oh, ground control to Major Tom. I can go on.
If you could take that off, it's actually a $20,000 helmet.
Pardon me.
I'll just wear it.
Now, Sally Ride, you were in training for your third mission into space on the Challenger space shuttle when something terrible happened in 1986.
Yes, when the Challenger exploded in 1986, that was devastating for me. Those people were like family.
Oh.
It also meant that I wasn't going to go into space again, most likely. And I found out when I was on a commercial flight, I was very upset by it. It was a national tragedy.
Oh, Sally Ride, I can only imagine that pain.
It's okay.
The Challenger explosion had a great affect on you because in 1987, you ended up leaving NASA. You just left!
I made it my next mission after the Challenger missions to show girls that you can be a scientist. Can do really whatever you want to do. If you are observant and you're curious and you use your brain, that's what I devoted my life to.
Look, it's me and no gravity.
Ooh, Sally Ride.
Anywho, thank you for being a woman. Thank you for being a genius. Thank you for not becoming a tennis pro. And thank you, most of all, Sally Ride, for being you.
It's been memorable.
See you next time on Herstory.